explorers, it's Justin again. Last time we saw each other, we were exploring the shallow waters of the ocean at the beach. But then, something amazing happened. As you can see, we are not exploring on land today. No way, we are out on the water. We're using this submarine to find that fascinating creature that jumped out of the water and see what its life is like in the ocean. We've been cruising around, scanning the water, but so far we haven't run into the big fellow we're looking for. This creature's pretty elusive, huh, Mia?
Oh, but wait, look over there! Did you see that tail?
Something big is over there. It has to be what we're looking for. Let's get closer. Ah, there it is!
What an amazing creature.
Oh, what's that on its head? Is there water coming out of it? Huh. What type of animal has a hole on the top of its head? Is it a fish? We need to get a closer look. Time to take this submarine underwater. Whoa, look at the size of this thing. It's huge. Look, it has fins and a tail to help it swim. It seems to have very smooth skin, too. That's interesting. Fish have scales, so it must not be one. And that hole on top of its head, what could that be for? Water came out of it, but does something else go in? What do you think? What could it be for? Pause here and write your prediction in your field notes. Huh. I don't see any gills for breathing like fish have, so I'm wondering, could that hole be for breathing? Maybe the water goes out so oxygen can go in. So we know this animal definitely isn't a fish, but what is it? If it's not using gills to breathe, there must be something else helping it get air. Like lungs. Okay, so this has to be a mammal. Mia, I think I need some assistance. Oh, this animal is a whale. Whales are mammals that live in the ocean. Do you remember what makes something a mammal? Mammals breathe air using lungs. Whales use their blowhole to breathe in oxygen, just like we thought. And the water that goes into the air isn't actually coming from inside their body. It's just excess water that stayed on top of their head when they came to the surface. And look, there's a baby too. Mammals give birth to live young, feed their babies milk, and stay close to them for a while as they grow up. Mammals also have hair or fur. Huh, I don't see any fur or hair on these whales. Let's zoom in and see if we can find some. Oh, whales do have some hair, just not very much. These bumps on their faces are actually hair follicles. Each one grows a single hair, just one. These hairs help them navigate their environment or detect nearby objects in the water, especially as babies. Whales are even more fascinating up close. I'm so happy we found one today. And what's this heading our way? It's a dolphin! Dolphins and whales are a lot alike. They both breathe using the blowholes on top of their heads, so they both swim close to the surface of the water to get air when they need it. Dolphins give birth and feed their babies milk. And like whales, dolphins are born with some hair around their mouth. Those hairs go away as they get older. Mia, do you hear that? Is it coming from one of those whales? Does it sound like they're kind of Singing? Oh, whales sing to each other to communicate? They use a range of high and low pitched noises that are able to travel really far underwater. So this helps them communicate with other whales that are far away. This long range communication is crucial because whales can be spread out across very long distances. Sometimes they use noises for echolocation. Echolocation is when animals send out sound waves that bounce off fish and other things in the ocean. And when these sound waves come back, the animal can hear where things are, even if they can't see them. Whales and dolphins both use this skill to locate food and stay aware of their surroundings. Dolphins don't sing, though. They make more of a clicking or chirping noise. And remember the whale jumping out of the water? Dolphins do this too. What do you think they're doing? And why? Pause here to record your prediction in your field notes. Then we'll talk about it together. So, what exactly are they doing? This jumping out of the water has a special name, breaching. Scientists think they do this in order to communicate, clean bits of seaweed and creatures off of their bodies, or even just have fun. For dolphins, breaching also helps them swim faster. Wow, I never knew whales and dolphins were mammals, just like us. They're super smart, breathe air, communicate with sounds, and even jump out of the water. Hey, wait, that thing coming towards us looks different. Is that a dolphin? Or a shark? I guess we have a few more things to explore before we take the submarine back. I'm sure glad we're in here. The wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey!